We will first declare the node structure because this is our custom data structure that we are building. Int data struct node star next, and this N should be capital. It should match the name of the node we have given, right? Only thing you need to remember is this node here, I can remove struct keyword. I can write only node star next. This means it is just storing the address of next. So if we are at one node, we can go to the next node following this next pointer. The linked list nodes that you see, these are not contiguous in memory. It's possible that first node is at memory address 1000, second is at 5000, third is at 2000. So in memory, they are scattered at various places, and the way they are linked together is through this next address. And once you reach a node which is having next as null, you say, okay, that's my last view, I'm gone. So in C++, when we start writing linked list program, we'll always start with one function, create node. When we say create node, we need to get this kind of box from memory, and we will initialize that. So if we want to allocate memory for this structure, this structure has one int field and one pointer field. So int is 4 bytes, pointer is 4 bytes. So total 8 bytes memory we want. So how do we do memory allocation? So there is malloc function. So we'll stick to using malloc rather than using new function of C++. So we'll use malloc and free. So first we do malloc. Malloc wants from us how many bytes of memory you want. So we give size of node. So size of node will dynamically calculate that it has two fields, 4 bytes plus 4 bytes, 8 bytes. So we don't have to do manual calculation. And once we call malloc, malloc will return us the address of memory that is allocated in heap. That address we are storing in new node. So now we got, you can say we got a raw memory space which has garbage in it, and now we have to initialize two parts of it. One part is data, one part is next. What do we store in data part of new node? The data that we have been passed. So somebody asked us, create a node and put this data into it and give that node back to me. So we put this data, and the way we access the data portion is, if you have address of the node, you use arrow notation. New node, arrow data, and you are copying this data. Right. Next is the next pointer. There, what will we store? So in next, we'll always put null because we don't want any garbage to be there. So this is how we initialize both these fields, and ultimately we return new node. And reason we are starting with this is we will write functions in the linked list for insertion in the linked list, searching in the linked list, deletion in the linked list. Insertion function will use this function. So this is kind of the prerequisite for us to begin linked list program.